I've opened up the presentation we were working on in the previous video, and I will save this as ODP17 Custom Master Pages. In an earlier video, we looked at changing the background of a page or all pages by choosing one of the master pages from the sidebar master pages. In this video, we're going to look at creating our own custom master pages. I'll start by clicking on the master pages in the sidebar, and we see three sections used in this presentation, recently used, and available for use. I'm going to change the view. To do that, I'm going up into View and selecting Slide Master. Here we see the master pages we used when creating this presentation. And we also see that it matches up over to used in this presentation. Going back into the normal view, I'm going to do that by going into View, Normal. Here we see our slides once again. And we see that we do not use that inspiration master that's right here. I'm going back into the slide master view. This time, I'm going to use the shortcut from the standard toolbar. And we also have a shortcut on the toolbar to get back to our normal slide view. I want to add my logo as a watermark to the lower right corner of my entire presentation without changing anything else. To do that, I'm going to drag and drop my logo into the lower right-hand corner. I'm going to resize this and position it how I want. I'll make it a little smaller. And to make this a watermark, I'm going to go over to Properties, and I'm in the Graphics tab. All the others are minimized. I'm going to change this transparency to 75%. Now we've got the watermark on a single master page. I'm going to copy that and paste it onto the next master page. And we need to do this one at a time. I cannot select all and paste, but I can do it one at a time. And there we have it. Going back into the normal view, we see that we've got our watermark in the lower right-hand corner. I'm going back into my master pages, and I want to create a new master page. I'm going to make it similar to this vintage page here, and I'm picking the vintage page because it has a lot of features to it. I'm going to the top page, right-clicking, New Master. And the first thing I want to do is create a new background. I want to create a custom gradient, so I'm going up to the Format menu, going down to Object and Shape, clicking on the area. Now I'm going into Gradients. This top color, I'm going to make orange 10. And the bottom one, I will make orange 8. You can play with these other values and try them out to see what they do. I've covered them all in previous tutorials, so I'm only going to cover the gradient here. I'm going to add, and I will call this orange 10.8 and click OK. You can also add hatchings and colors and bitmaps the same way, clicking OK. Now I want to add my new gradient to the background. To do that, I will right click on my slide and select Format Slide. I'm going to the Background tab, changing this to Gradient, and scrolling down to the bottom, I see the new gradient, Orange 810. Clicking OK gives us our new gradient background. Looking at our vintage slide, we've got this bar at the top. I don't want to change our title text bar, so I'm going to add in a new one. I'm going over to Basic Shapes, selecting a rectangle, and I'm going to make this pretty close to the rectangle that's already in there. I'm going into the area, and instead of a bitmap, I want to make this a color. I do not want this blue, so I'm coming down to select the color to apply, scrolling down to the bottom, and I'll make it this orange 9. It has a blue outline. I'm going to turn off the outline. And we also have a red shadow on here, if we look closely. So I'm going to enable the shadow. But instead of 6, I'm going to make this 2. And I'm going to change it from gray to red. Now we've got our shadow. The next thing we want to do is add this ribbon on here. To add in the ribbon, I'm coming up to the shapes, and we do not have a ribbon shape. So I'm going to add in a rectangle. Now I'm going to add in a diamond shape over that and make it right here at the bottom. Position this on the bottom of our rectangle. Now what I'm going to do is select my diamond, hold down shift and select my rectangle, right click, come down to shapes, and I want subtract. That gives me my ribbon shape from my rectangle. Going back into properties, I'm going to change my area from a bitmap to gradient, and I will make the top color red and the bottom color gray. We have one more thing to do. We need to bring our title text to the front. I'm going to right click and arrange send to back. Now we can see our title text. I'm going to make that box a little smaller so it doesn't go over the ribbon. The last thing we want to do is add the watermark. I'm going to right click on that, copy, come back to our new custom page and paste it there. I'm going back to the normal view, going to our master pages. I see our new slide right up here. So I can select that and paste it in to our selected slides. Now we've got our new custom slide in our slideshow. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.